Hello, Lauren here with Lauren Elizabeth Animal Art, and I help beginner through professional level artists reduce stress while mastering animal art. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you 5 easy ways that you can paint faster using acrylics. And to demonstrate this, I'm going to be using this black lab puppy named Sapphire. So guys, let's get started. Right, so if you would like to paint Sapphire in real time, I have a traceable printout, a reference photo, a list of materials, and class notes, which I will be adding to my online Animal Art Masterclass linked down below. And I'd also like to thank those of you that voted in my public YouTube community. This month, the majority vote came to how to paint faster. And then next week, I'll be posting a video on how to capture pet expressions, so look for that. My first tip for helping you to paint faster is to shave off 10 minutes off of your normal painting time. And then once you reach your goal, try and take off another 10 minutes. When I first started painting pets, it would take me about 3, 4, sometimes 5 days to complete a painting like this, an 8x10, one dog pet portrait. Now it takes me about 2 to 3 hours tops, and sometimes I can even make that a little shorter. I used to work for Chewy.com, and we had to complete a minimum of 10 pet portraits per week. And that was quite stressful, but it was a great thing because it really forced me to not get held up on detail and just to move on to the next step. And that leads me to tip number 2. It makes an enormous difference if you have a step-by-step process that you can follow whenever you're painting. And that's why I've created a 12-step process for how to paint pets. And this is actually something I also apply to my wildlife paintings, but I vary it sometimes, but for the most part, I'm repeating the same steps over and over again. This is the 12-step process that I teach in my online Animal Art Masterclass. And what it also does is it really helps me to visualize what I'm going to paint before I paint it in terms of color and composition. I don't often create a sketch or do anything online to plan out my paintings. I kind of plan them out in my head, and although things always change and sometimes they change so much that it doesn't look anything like I envisioned, but for the most part I have some basic idea as to how that painting is going to turn out, and that's because I know these steps so well. Tip number 3 is actually kind of my artist style, which is where I like to pull colors in from one area and layer them over top another. So I will mix up one color, I'll test it out to see if it's the right color on my canvas. If it is, I actually try to fit it in any area that I see it has that correct value. What this forces me to do is to focus on covering up all the white first before honing in to all those little details, which I usually apply with my medium and my light values. So you save the detail parts for the very end, but you focus on just covering up the white and building up those layers at the beginning. Tip number 4 may be kind of unusual, but paint something you love. Paint something that gets you excited. I notice that I work slower and I'm just a bit more apprehensive when I'm painting something that I just am, my heart's not attached to. But passion gives you momentum, and I find that I go faster when I'm excited about a painting than when I'm kind of dreading it. I feel like the way you begin a painting always impacts how you finish it. So if I begin a painting just completely excited about the colors that I'm about to use, the story behind the animal, the view or composition, the layout, everything, if that all just excites me, I'm more motivated to kind of push through any of the challenges that come up. Tip number 5 has really worked for me when I run into troubles and there's something that I just don't understand how to paint. And that is I leave it for the very end. I get all the other parts that I can completed, and then I save that for the very last. This keeps me in the flow, and it keeps that momentum going while also preventing me from overthinking it and just getting too held up on details that might actually not impact the painting overall. What it also does is it helps me to simplify what I need to do when I complete other steps. Sometimes it just clicks once I complete the other parts, and that's the last thing that is left to paint. And then it also sometimes causes me to change my painting so it looks entirely different in a very good way. So getting held up on that area was something that ended up bringing more life to my painting. I can't tell you how many times the things I thought were mistakes actually ended up developing my artist style. Like when I was trying to cover up a mistake using glasses or a bow tie, I ended up liking that so much that I took it into the next pet portraits. Or when I accidentally added blue to the dog nose. And now I love it so much, almost all my animals have either a purple or blue nose now. Alright guys, I hope that was helpful for you. I honestly would be more than happy to answer any of your questions in the comment section down below. And just remember, you never want to speed up your process if it's going to sacrifice quality. That should be the most important thing above speed. Even though it's very impressive to paint fast, you just want to ultimately create a beautiful painting. Alright guys, I'll see you next week for another animal painting tutorial where we'll talk about how to capture pet expressions in your pet portraits. Bye!